What's the longest time you spent playing video games in a day? Video games are a popular form of entertainment, not just for kids and teenagers, as it's often portrayed, but for adults as well. As of 2016, the average American gamer is actually 35 years old. Gamers spend 3 billion hours a week in front of their screens. Data shows that more than 150 million people are playing video games regularly in the United States. With that many hours spent gaming, you have to wonder how this affects your body, as well as the most important organ in your body, the brain. There are a multitude of factors to ponder, like how video games affect your posture or how the exposure to blue light emitted by the screen affects your hormone regulation and sleep. But what we want to know is how it influences and changes our brain. Does it make us smarter, improve our reaction time, or does it have the potential to destroy us? Most people know that gaming can be addictive, and researchers refer to it as a phenomenon called the internet gaming disorder. But playing video games has both its pros and cons. For example, certain video games can enhance the gamer's attention and memory, but on the other hand, it can also expose them to extreme violence and aggression. Being exposed to violence-themed games will lead to desensitization and affect certain brain regions that are linked to attention and emotional processes. A study by Brad Bushman at Ohio State University found that violent games like Grand Theft Auto decreased the player's empathy towards situations in real life. In a study consisting of a large group of teenage boys, after playing the violent video game, the subjects reported significantly lower empathy and compassion when shown a photo of a female victim of domestic violence. Not only does it increase violence and aggression, but it has also been seen to increase the bystander effect in people, cause dysregulated emotions, as well as desensitization to death and moral obligations. This is troubling as it shows that negativity and bad role models in games can shape the perceptions and behaviors of people, especially children and teens. Another downside of playing video games is that it can lead to addiction, changing the brain both structurally and functionally. When gamers are exposed to certain cues, it causes the same brain responses in areas associated with pleasure and reward as those seen in other types of addiction, like drug and gambling. Gaming can take up a lot of your time and affect other responsibilities that you have. This can cause serious issues with sleeping, eating, work in school, and lead to conflicts with others, immense stress, and deteriorating health. We have to be careful, especially since video games have become more and more accessible to us through our smartphones. Now we can play it almost whenever and wherever we want. On the other hand, recent scientific studies have found that certain video games may actually have some benefits for us. Mark Pallas and his team recently gathered about 115 different scientific studies and summarized them to determine how video games affect the brain and our behavior. The results show that not only will playing video games change the brain's performance, but its structure as well. For example, video games can lead to improvements in both selective and sustained attention. Moreover, areas involved in attention become more efficient, requiring less activation to sustain. Visual spatial ability is also enhanced, showing enlargements in the right hippocampus in both long-term gamers and volunteers. In addition, exposure to task-oriented games improve the individual's overall skill acquisition. A study conducted at the University of California, Irvine by neurobiologists saw that playing games that were three-dimensional could help increase the development of memory ability. Participants aged 60 to 80 were assigned to different groups with 2D and 3D games and completed memory tests before and after participating in the games. It was found that the 3D games improved memory by 12%, the same amount that is generally lost with age between the ages of 40 to 70. Specially designed video games, especially strategy games, seem to help fight against mental illnesses involving aging and neurodegeneration, like dementia and Alzheimer's disease. These studies also seem to suggest that video games have the potential to improve mood and memory in those with mild cognitive impairments as well as depression. Video games are still quite new, and so is the research on it. Pallas says, "We focused on how the brain reacts to video game exposure, but these effects do not always translate to real-life changes. It is likely that video games have both positive and negative aspects, and it is essential that we embrace this complexity."